Hello guys, so on today's video I wanted to show you how to diagnose your ignition switch if you have a problem with that switch and needs to be replaced. So you're trying to turn on the ignition and you don't have any lights on your display. It will also be, this video will be good for the machines with this type of a throttle handle. So no matter which machine you have, this handle without with the display beside or with the built-in. Okay, so you turn on the ignition and you don't have any lights, but you know that your batteries are okay because you can push the lightning button. If your machine is equipped with a fob, you can push it and you see that it's working fine and your machine is actually moving. So obviously you have a problem with your ignition switch that is not working. So shut off your power, which is pushing unlock button or lock button on your older machine. And you will need to remove this body kit to inspect it. So remove this knob and two bolts on the side, two on this side, and one nut underneath of the seat to lift up the plastic body kit. Unplug your speed switch and you have to inspect your ignition switch. Okay, so you have to wiggle it. Which plug exactly? Well, in my case it was pretty visual and simple. It was just unplugged, maybe from the shipping or other reasons. So let's see if it's gonna work now. Okay, now it's working. So in my case it was a pretty simple fix. Just plug in back your plastic plug. And just to make sure that it's not going to get loose next time, use a zip tie, you know, like here through the wires, and put inside and use a zip tie that it will hold it together. I'm showing you how to use that zip tie and how to hold it together on a different plug. This is not the lock, because I'm going to show you how to diagnose it if your plug was plugged in but your ignition is still not working. So each ignition switch is going to be marked with a sticker lock, or maybe power switch or ignition switch. So it doesn't matter what kind of name you're gonna have. If you want to make sure that's the one, just wiggle the wire that coming from the ignition and you know this is the one that you need. Now what you want to do, You want to take a regular piece of wire or like a paper clip. In my case, I find it the most convenient. And you wanted to connect those two wires together on this lock. The wires together that go into the controller to see if your machine is going to power on. You're going to see a little spark. Don't worry about that. That's not dangerous for life. So now I jump those two wires on the ignition lock plug coming from the controller, and I see that my machine is working okay. So I know for sure that my switch needs to be replaced because it's not passing, connecting those two wires together. It's not passing power. Another method, if you have a regular multimeter and if you want to double check. And you can check this wire plug for continuity, I mean the switch itself. So you want to turn on the ignition, and if your ignition is working, it's supposed to pass power. It's working fine. When I turn it off, it does not make any sound. And when I turn it on, it's making sound. So this is called continuity test for the ignition. But if you don't have that multimeter, you can use it simply. You can test your simply with a paper clip. Well, I hope it was pretty clear for you how to test the ignition switch on the S and X model only. Thank you. Bye.